and rain. That's crazy. All right, we're going to open up in prayer. Father God, we love you, Lord. Thank you for this beautiful day. Thank you for this weather. Lord, we bless you. We lift up our government, Father God, and our president. Lord, let them make the right decisions for us, Lord. And Father God, we lift up all our soldiers, and we thank you for them, Lord. Keep them protected, keep them safe, Lord. Thank you for our police officers, Lord, that keep us safe. And Lord, we just love you so much. We praise your name. Lord, we lift up all the churches. We lift up a passion play to you, Lord. Let people come from everywhere to go there. And we love you so much. We ask you, Father God, take us completely out, that we give you all the praise and all the glory and everything that is done, Lord. It is about you and not about us, Father God. And we thank you for giving us your Son, Lord. We thank you and we love you. In the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. Amen.
Amen.
All right. Open your
Chuck, you're not on.
Okay, fine. Okay.
Can you hear me now?
Now I'm on.
Yeah. Hello, hello. I hope everybody had a great Christmas.
Yes,
yeah, did everybody have a good Christmas?
Yes.
Yes, we got New Year's coming up. Woohoo! We are going to be open on Christmas Eve. New Year's Eve. Not open Christmas Eve, we're closing Christmas Eve.
Yeah, probably. Next year we will be.
Because we had a lot of people coming that were in need of not only food but prayer and all that. So Chuck was so gracious to go out and help them and talk to them, pray with them and all that. So yeah. So we probably will have to
Christmas.
Redo.
We won't be
next
closed
year.
On Christmas Eve again.
That's when they need
just too much stress and too much in need in our area that we. And that's okay, because Chuck and I can do it. You guys can hang, and we'll take that. We'll take that. All right, so we did have a great Christmas. We got to spend time with our kids, got a couple of grandkids here with
us.
No fights. No cat fights.
Yes.
It was good.
Awesome.
It was awesome. So.
That's always a bonus.
Yes.
Prayers answered, right? That's what I said. Thank you, Jesus. Okay, so this last week we were closed on Friday, so we had less of a count, but we still have a huge amount of people that were coming. We had 350 people through the pantry, 127 families through the pantry, and 274 meals.
Wow.
Yes.
Just meals. So that was a lot.
Yes.
And I know there's a lot of people out today. Some of them text said they weren't feeling well or whatever their situation is,
traveling.
Out of town. So we need to please keep them in your prayers, traveling back home, and you know that they heal and get feeling better. So please, yes. And then New Year's is right around the corner. Can you believe it?
Yoo-hoo!
January, we are going to do our bingo, and that is going to be the last Saturday of the month, and we'll pick up and do that every month again. So that'll be the 29th from 4 to 7. So we do have some gifts that were left over from our Dirty Santa. So you may see them again.
Bring more gifts.
Like so we do need more gifts. So did you get something that you don't want or don't need?
Perfect timing.
Perfect timing, yeah.
Yes.
Hey, come on in, girl.
There's some seats up here, honey.
Thank you, Jesus.
Yes, so we're just going to keep going. And so write that down each Saturday. Last Saturday of each month, we will be doing bingo again. So we will need gifts, and we need people just to come and hang out and have fun. And it's fellowship time. It's fun. And eat lots of spaghetti. So.
Yes. And Marty's here. We've been
Marty's
praying
here.
For you, Marty.
Yes.
I mean it.
Amen.
Yes.
Your prayers
Jesus.
There, too.
Walking
yes.
in the
Walking
door.
In.
Praise God. Man, Lord ain't done with you yet, girl.
That's right.
And,
sorry to disrupt.
Oh, you're fine. And we're not going to have a band playing today because Andy's out of town. And I would I got to mention that a friend of ours passed away this week, Kenneth Knight. He was a big biker guy that more or less built everything here, the fence, that wall. Every time you look at that wall, think of Kenneth, man, because he did a great job, man. And he will be missed, and we love him. And I know absolutely no details on nothing, so don't ask, because I don't know.
Yeah,
but keep him and his family lifted up in prayer.
Yes.
And I kind of hate saying anything on video here.
I need to share something later, if it's okay.
Okay. And you know, Kenneth was a good guy, and he will be missed, man.
Is he the guy that wore the bandana?
He was a big teddy bear, man.
Big teddy bear, man. He had a big old heart. And like I said, he did a lot of building here. And he was very helpful, and we love him. So, we're going to play some praise and worship music. We're going to listen to it. We're going to pray. Praise God. And I do want you, if you feel led that you need prayer, jump on up here and we'll pray for you. The altar is open. I love this time when I don't have to play and I can actually get to praise God with all of you. And it's take this time and thank Him, you know, for all that the Lord's given you this year. You know, this is going to be the end of this year, so we should have a lot to be thankful for. And even though it might have been a really rough year for some of us, still rough. Just be thankful, you know. And if you need prayer, there's something that you're going through, or you know somebody is going through something that they need prayer, let's get on it. And I believe with all my heart that when you ask the Lord and you truly believe that He's going to take care of business, I believe that. I don't think that we're just praying just to be praying. I believe that the Lord is listening to us. So if you have something, you need a healing. You are thankful for the healing you got. You need the Lord to take some kind of habit away from your whatever you need help for. You need help on your rent. You need help on anything. You can ask the Lord.
Yes.
And I'll tell you, standing up here, Cup of Love is proof that it's always right in time. Man.
Yes.
Always
yes.
Right in time.
Yes.
As soon as you're going, oh, what am I going to do? Lord, I need this. I'm out. And here comes a truckload of it, you know. And you just keep faithful.
Yes.
And keep your eyes on the Lord. Don't give up. And when you get put through these trials, because we all have to go through trials, you just hang on the Lord, man. You ask Him for help. Just ask Him to save you. Martin, before we do that, what you got?
Okay, Billy, where are you?
I ain't seen Billy. Hey, Billy! We miss you.
We need to Billy up here first.
Billy, come on. Mama said. Hey, give me a hug. We miss you. Golly, we've been praying for you, girl.
I appreciate it.
Thank you, Jesus.
Man. Okay, my husband.
I love you, brother.
Was the, he was the only one that recognized that knew what happened to me. He's seen it, and I didn't, so I'll let him go first.
Uh-oh.
And I was asked by the Lord to share this with you today, so.
I guess you have to get up and go to the restroom, so help you get up, went to the restroom, got cleaned up, went back leg down, and I was laying there, started dozing off. And I heard a big, little sound. I'm coming. I jumped up off that bed, ran around there. She had a look on her face like a zombie looking at you. There's no feature. There's all just like that, and blood was just rolling. Mm-hmm. And I got in there, got her cleaned up, turned around, and got her set up there far enough where I could unlock the door, so I called 911. They said, "We're on our way, we're just about there, we know who you are." So I said, "In here." I'm going back there to her. "Well, we only have 5 units of blood. She lost 3. She is almost dead."
Mm-hmm. 3 liters.
That was. And instead of getting her laid down, got her up, one got on each side of her, helped her walk out the door. Mm-hmm. She still does not know this day about nothing. What happened, what went on, nothing. And then turned around, got her on the gurney, lost a little more blood. They got her from there in the ambulance. They gave her a IV, and her blood pressure was only 90 over 45. Mm. She almost died.
Yes.
I fed the house. So after they said, "Where is she going?" I said, "No place but Washington Regional. That's the only place that knows of her, about her, who she is. That's the best one."
Yeah.
They said, "No problem. That's where she's going." They said, "We have a thing though. We're not going to be able to take her in this ambulance here. Yeah. It's a big truck. She wouldn't make it." So they took her up there to that blue healthcare building for Tyson. And I had my radio on, I was listening and watching. And I heard him on the radio, and I seen him coming, and he made a loop around, sat down right at that building. They took him from that ambulance into that ambulance, and I just seen it rise, and all she just, like that, it was gone. She said she never wanted to fly. I said, "You're glad you." I said, "You're probably glad you weren't coherent."
Yeah.
Why?
Why?
You flew. And it was a fast ride.
Yeah. Like, yeah. Well,
best wings. Yes.
Thanks to Jesus Christ.
Yes.
My husband has dealt with dead bodies and worked in the morgues and all that stuff. And he says he never wants to see anything like that ever again.
Yeah. There wasn't so nothing I had done or seen with other bodies.
Mm-hmm.
When I looked at that was
right.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Thank you, Jesus.
I want to tell you that all those things that happened to me, at that time, the Lord was already working miracles in my life.
Amen.
He took, he made it to the where I go stay with my sister for a week. And me and my brothers and sisters all had a visit one night, and all we talked about was Jesus and God.
Amen.
And
yes.
God.
Yes.
So that was a miracle. We had to talk together in 7 years.
Wow.
And then another miracle is, the Lord, I didn't realize it till I was thinking one day about how the Lord's had me on this journey toward forgiveness.
Yes.
Because I would think of somebody using, I'd think, "Oh man, I hate her, I hate him." And now when I think of them, it's like, "Oh, I love him, they're nice people." So he's changed my whole heart.
Yes.
He's changed my whole life.
That's huge.
And he's made my kids realize how much, you know, I mean to them. And I already knew, but they, you know, I didn't realize it. But then also another thing too that I have found out is when you almost die like that, you realize when you get better, you realize that there's people in your life,
that's true,
that you want to say thank you to, "I love you," or "You mean the world to me," or
yes,
something. So I know each and every person in this church.
Yeah.
I've known you for seems like years. Some people longer than others, too. But anyway, I just wanted to say that Patty Trevor.
We love you.
I love you guys. I just want to say, Mrs. Betty, Mama Betty, I just want to say that I think.
I missed you.
Missed you, too. I just want to say that thank you, and Jim, Jimmy, thank you for being a part of my life. Thank you for being there for me. Thank you for praying for me. And all of those who prayed for me while I was going through this thing, I want to thank them, too. Now, I still can't bend over. I still can't walk very far.
Taking baby steps.
I couldn't even walk when I first got out my ass. We had that. But then I got, now I can walk comfortably by myself. But I'm still weak and I'm still.
Can you put your hands up?
Yeah. And I'm still weak. But you know what? That don't matter because I'm still here.
That's right.
And the only thing that really did to me that was bad was it put a fear in my heart that I'm going to die. So I'm really careful about what I do because I'm afraid I'm going to die. And the doctor said if I got a little bit of counseling, that would probably change too. So,
yes.
But I know that if the Lord was going to take me, he would have taken me that night.
Amen.
So, why would he feel me and then take me when he could have taken me that night? So, and I know he's not done with me yet.
No.
And I love you guys so much.
God's will.
And I just want to say thank you so much for being
here. Well, let's play some praise and worship music. There we go. We got somebody that's happy to be alive.
Amen.
Jesus.
Amen.
Go ahead, brother.
I'm trading my sorrows, I'm trading my shame, I'm laying them down for the joy of the Lord. I'm treating my sickness, I'm treating my pain, I'm laying them down for the joy of the Lord. We say yes Lord, yes Lord, yes, yes Lord, yes Lord, yes Lord, yes, yes Lord. Yes, Lord, yes, Lord, yes, yes, Lord, amen. I'm pressed but not crushed, persecuted, not abandoned, struck down but not destroyed. I am blessed beyond the curse, for his promise will endure, that his joy is gonna be my strength. Though the sorrow may last for the night, his joy comes with I'm
Jesus. us more than anything.
Thank you, Father God, for your word, Lord. We believe everything in this to be written by you and to be true, Lord. Let it be easy for us to read, easy for us to understand, Father God. We just love you and we praise your holy name. In the name of Jesus Christ, amen.
Amen.
Amen. Well, man, I do miss the band. Andy, we miss you. And so I'm going to read the whole thing, but we're going to go over, we're going to start in the middle of, well, not even in the middle, in 7, because there's so much going on in Revelation 3 that we're going to get 3 weeks out of it, and we already did 1 week, so we're going to do one more. And man, I just ask you, please take time out of your life to read your Bible, because if you got questions, man, God is awesome. Man, thank you, Father God. Love you, Lord. Okay, here we go. To the angel of the church, yeah, don't try to follow it, because I'm going to catch up. I'm going to start reading at the beginning. We'll come back to that in a minute. Right? Oh, look at you, man. I love you, brother. Man, he's got it going on back there. All right. To the angel of the church in Sardis, right. These are the words of him who holds the 7 spirits of God and the 7 stars. I know your deeds. You have a reputation of being alive, but you are dead. Wake up. Strengthen what remains and is about to die. For I have found your deeds unfinished in the sight of my God. Remember, therefore, what you have received and heard. Hold it fast and repent. But if you do not wake up, I will come like a thief, and you will not know what time I will come to you. Yet you have a few people in Sardis who have not soiled their clothes. They will walk with me, dressed in white, for they are worthy. The one who is victorious will, like them, be dressed in white. I will never blot out the name of that person from the book of life, but will acknowledge that name before my Father and his angels. Whoever has ears, let them hear what the Spirit says to the churches. To the angel of the church in Philadelphia write, these are the words of him who is holy and true, who holds the key of David. He, what he opens, no one can shut, and what he shuts, no one can open. I know your deeds. See, I have placed before you an open door that no one can shut. I know that you have little strength, yet you have kept my word and have not denied my name. I will make those who are of the synagogue of Satan, who claim to be Jews, though they are not, but are liars. I will make them come and fall down at your feet and acknowledge that I have loved you. Since you have kept my command to endure patiently, I will also keep you from the hour of trial that is going to come on the whole world to test the inhabitants of the earth. I am coming soon. Hold on to what you have so that no one will take your crown. The one who is victorious, I will make a pillar in the temple of my God. Never again will they leave it. I will write on them the name of my God and the name of the city of my God, the New Jerusalem, which is coming down out of heaven from my God. And I will also write on them my new name. Whoever has ears, let them hear what the Spirit says to the churches. To the angel of the church in Laodicea, write, these are the words of the Amen, the faithful and true witness, the ruler of God's creation. I know your deeds, that you are neither cold nor hot. I wish you were either one or the other. So because you are lukewarm, neither hot nor cold, I am about to spit you out of my mouth. You say, I am rich. I have acquired wealth and do not need a thing. But you do not realize that you are wretched, pitiful, poor, blind, and naked. I counsel you to buy from me gold refined in the fire, so you can become rich, and white clothes to wear, so you can cover your shameful nakedness, and salve to put on your eyes, so you can see. Those whom I love, I rebuke and discipline. So be earnest and repent. Here I am. I stand at the door and knock. If anyone hears my voice and opens the door, I will come in and eat with that person, and they with me. Man. Whew. Thank you, Jesus. Man. Sorry. To the one who is victorious, I'll give the right to sit with me on my throne, just as I was victorious and sat down with my Father on his throne. Whoever has ears, let them hear what the Spirit says to the churches. Whew. Thank you, Father God, for your word, Lord. Let's use this word, Lord, to get closer to you. I'm sorry, guys. Thank you, Father.
Are you okay?
Yeah, man. Man, when the Lord comes knocking,
yes.
Man, you better be listening. You better open up that door and let him in.
Yes.
Thank you, Father. Woo! Glory. All right. We're going to start off in verse 7. To the church in Philadelphia. To the angels of the church in Philadelphia write, these are the words of him who is holy and true, who holds the key of David. What he opens, no one can shut, and what he shuts, no one can open. For the key of David, Jesus holds. Jesus holds the key of David, the entrance into heaven. He opens the door to heaven to some and closes it to others. He is the keeper of the key to the door of heaven. We had this discussion yesterday, Dave. Have you ever heard somebody say, I don't think we can say who goes to heaven and who doesn't? When we tell people that Jesus is the only way to heaven, we're not saying that we have the authority to make the decisions, that decision. We are announcing that the decision has already been made. Jesus said, I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father but through me. John 14:6. Man, that is powerful. And the best thing you can do for somebody is to show them the faith in Jesus Christ is the only way to heaven. There is no other way to get to heaven but through Jesus Christ. If anybody's trying to tell you this, that, and the other, it's a lie. The Bible, this is the book that we go by right here.
Amen.
No other book. Don't take my word for it. Take this word right here for it. Verse 8, I know your deeds. See, I have placed before you an open door that no one can shut. I know that you have little strength, yet you have kept my word and have not denied my name. In this verse, Jesus uses the metaphor of an open door to describe an opportunity for ministry for the church at Philadelphia. Jesus said the believers had little strength, meaning they were small in number and had little cultural influence, but their size didn't matter to Christ. All that mattered to him was that they remained true by keeping his word and not denying his name. Their opportunity to spread the gospel would continue because the door Christ opened was on, which no one could shut. There's only one reason God left you and me here on this earth instead of taking us to heaven when we were saved. He left us here to spread the gospel to as many people as possible. And like the believers in Philadelphia, we are to take advantage of every open door God puts before us to spread the gospel. You know, it'd be so easy for when we give our life to Christ that it'd be like, all right, come on home. No, He wants us to get out there and tell people about the love of Christ and what Christ is. And this is the best thing, what Christ has done for you, how Christ changed your life.
Amen.
With that witnessing and your testimony, that's going to help people. And since we're on that, real quick, I am going to have a list, a piece of paper down here at the altar, that if you would like, we're going to start it back up this next year at the beginning. You've got to give me a little time to get it together and get a little high tech, because, I'm not real high tech on computers, but I'm going to try to learn as fast as possible, and we're going to do testimonies again, and we're going to record them and put them on the internet. And we're going to do it different, though, this time. We're not going to do it live. We're going to do it so that we can edit it and people can do it to their convenience at their time when they're ready and they can come in, because I don't care what day it is, and it's just going to be us. So keep that in mind. Well, and the whole world once we put it on there. But, you know, with the, instead of doing it live like we did before, we'll be able to go, that person would go, man, please, you know, I don't want that part on there. And we can take care of that, hopefully, since I get to figuring that out. But our testimonies, you think you have it, you don't have a testimony, watch out, man. Lord will give you one. And they're very powerful. And what I love about it is something that you've went through, somebody might be going through right then, or they went through it. And it's going to change lives. I truly believe that, because that old self is gone. And if you can show somebody the new you, man, you're going to help change lives, because God's going to use you. So, with that being said, I'm going to have something written down. And throughout the week, I don't care, Monday through Friday, you come up here and you write that down, write your name down, and when we get it going. And be working on it, because this is the deal. I'm sorry to stray from this, but your testimony, you have a lot. Like, for me, for instance, I couldn't get nothing done in 45 minutes. So you give your testimony of what the Lord puts on your heart for that time, and then you save another. Because it, more than likely, it's going to be a whole nother topic, because we've been through stages in life that we've been this and that and that, and went through this and that and the other. Mm-hmm. So keep that in mind, that just give a little bit of your testimony and then come back another time and give some more. Because your testimony is going to keep going until you're in the ground. Hallelujah. Okay, so back to this. I love you guys. Verse 9. I will make those who are of the synagogue of Satan, who claim to be Jews, though they are not, but are liars, I will make them come and fall down at your feet and acknowledge that I have loved you. Well, just as in Smyrna, that's what I like to call it. I'm sure that isn't it. Believers in Philadelphia were excommunicated from the Jewish synagogue and may have had a difficulty doing business in the city, and I bet they were struggling because they gave their life to Christ and they were following something totally different. But because they remained faithful to the teaching of Christ, Jesus promised that one day, instead of being persecuted, they would be vindicated. Verse 10, since you have kept my command to endure patiently, I will also keep you from the hour of trial that is going to come on the whole world to test the inhabitants of the earth. Well, some believe that I will also keep you from the hour of trial means there will be a future time of great tribulation from which true believers will be spared. Others interpret this to mean that the church will go through the time of the tribulation and that God will keep them strong in the midst of it. Still others believe this refers to times of great distress in general, the church's suffering through the ages. You know, we cannot interpret from just this verse when or for how long Christians will experience the hour of trial. You know, today, millions of Christians are suffering and dying at the hands of godless tyrants. Throughout the world, to them, the hour of trial has already begun. Whenever Christians suffer, Christ promises protection of their eternal souls. There's going to come a time, I believe in my heart, that, you know, if we don't die of natural causes, if we're here long enough, that people are going to be on us. They're not going to like us. I get it all the time, but I'm in this situation. But I mean, for a normal Christian, I think time is coming that people aren't going to be very friendly at all to Christians. And you know, I pray that the Lord gives me strength every time that happens to me, that I can stand up and be faithful, you know. Because I know it's rough. But man, our Jesus, He loves us. He died for us. We should be eager to die for Him. Verse 11, I am coming soon. Hold on to what you have so that one will take your crown. Ugh. Christians have different gifts, abilities, experiences, and maturity. God doesn't expect us all to be and act the same. No. But He does expect us to hold on to what we have, to continue in using our resources for Him. You may be a new believer and feel that your faith and spiritual strength are little. Use what you have to live for Christ, and God will commend you. You know, I'll tell you what, guys. Everything that you have is from God. As soon as you get that in your head and you figure that out, man, life's going to be a whole lot easier for you. Because, first of all, if it's not glorifying Him, man, you'd be praying for God to take that out of your life. And that's a hard prayer. Because when you do that, you better get ready. Because whatever that is, it's going to get out of there. And man, what is so awesome, the Holy Spirit, once you are truly following Christ, the Holy Spirit's already got a hold of you anyways. And it's like, I know I need to quit doing that. Thank you, Lord. And He's going to put it on your heart, and you're going to put it down and be able to quit. And that goes with anything and everything. Somebody gets away from you that you said something stupid, say, Lord, put that person back in my path so I can straighten it out. Yeah. And guess what? They're going to come right around, and there they are, and you got the chance to do it. Because I'm telling you, our God is awesome, man. I believe with all my heart what I pray for, it's going to happen if it's His will. I believe that with all my heart. And if it's not, it ain't going to. Because He knows what's good for me. And I might not be praying at that time the right thing that is good for me. He might be going, you're praying that, but you better not let that happen because I know it's going to happen later on.
Right.
Well, that's right, because the brother right there, and he is wearing his cross. And brother,
right there.
I want you to know I was praying for your sister while we was praying, brother.
Yep.
Amen. Thank you.
Lift her up. Verse 12, the one who is victorious, I will make a pillar in the temple of my God. Never again will they leave it. I will write on them the name of my God and the name of the city of my God, the New Jerusalem, which is coming down out of heaven from my God. Woohoo! And I will also write on them my new name. Ah, that just gets me excited there. You know, I will make a pillar in the temple of my God. Never again will they leave it. There's a day coming when we will never have to move again.
Yay.
How cool is that going to be, man? Our resident will be protected. We will stay there forever. When Jesus promises the believers they would remain in His temple, He was speaking of their eternal security. They will occupy a city that can never be destroyed, the New Jerusalem, where nothing and no one can harm them ever again. Man, are you ready for that or what?
Yes.
Me too, man.
Yeah.
I will write on them the name of my God and the name of the city of my God, the New Jerusalem, which is coming down out of heaven for my God. And I will also write on them my new name. You know, writing your name on something shows ownership. He is saying, you belong to me. I'm going to take care of you. You know, how many of us wrote our name on something, and it's like, that's mine. I'm going to take care of that. I know everybody probably wrote something on their toy or something when they were younger. I'm guilty of it still. I'm a grown man. I write it on every tool, every cord that I've ever had, and everything's got my name on it. I mean, even these stupid mic stands, you know, it's just the way I did it, you know. And I wasn't even tweaking. That's the crazy part about it, man. I'm sober and I'm writing this on everything. What? Crazy. You know, but Jesus said the name He will write on us is my new name. What is Jesus' name? When Jesus came to earth, the first name, He came as a Savior. He was nailed to a cross, but 3 days later, He rose from the dead. I'm going to close with this. 40 days after, He ascended into heaven, and right now, He is seated at the right hand of God,
yes,
the Father. Woohoo! He has become the overcomer. Jesus could not have the title of overcomer until He passed from this life into the next life. In John 16:33, Jesus said, "In the world you have tribulation, but take courage. I have overcome the world."
Yes.
Praise God. And when you place your faith in Jesus Christ, you can be assured that one day when you pass from this life into the next, you too will experience what it means to overcome the world. Man. Praise God. But I got to finish this one off because I love the way how Jesus rolls, man. Verse 13, whoever has ears, let them hear what the Spirit says to the churches. I love how He says that, man. You better, huh? What? I'm listening, Lord. So, you know, I'm trying not to be a doom and gloom kind of guy up here, but I'm telling you, times are fixing to get rough.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
And they are. We've already seen it start. And I'm just thankful that I got Jesus in my heart at this time of this part of life that we're going through right now.
Mm-hmm.
And if you don't know that Jesus Christ came and died for your sins, man, everybody in here is saved. Thank you, Jesus. I know all of you. So, you know, be praying for your loved ones. And be, do not give up in prayer. You keep praying for that loved one to give their life to Christ. And, you know, we all have kids. And that's the hardest one. Amen. That's the hardest one, is to, your faith is not gonna, they can't ride on your faith, but you can pray for them. I had a mother-in-law, she prayed for me when I was in my worst. She prayed and prayed for years and years and years and years, and I thank God that I got saved before she passed, that she got to see a totally different Chuck. So don't give up. You keep on praying for them. Mm-hmm. And you, and especially with addiction, you know, so many of us have addictions and have been through being addicted to something, but our kids, man, they're messing around with a whole nother ball game, because now they are putting stuff in drugs to kill you. There's no getting high. You're going to get high and die. Right. That, I mean, and they're putting it in pot. They're putting it in stuff. People think they're doing meth, and it's that fentanyl, and it's killing them. And I'm telling you, man, we need to be praying for our kids. Because they're the ones that are out there that are really heavy into this stuff right now. I mean, not my kids in general, but all of our kids, you know? Yeah. And we just got to pray for protection and pray for them to give their life to Christ. And we truly, I don't know if you guys seen this, I really feel like we are seriously in the last of times. Mm-hmm. They put up, and I don't give the devil no credit, he sucks. Mm-hmm. They put up a statue of a baby of Satan, and they're trying to get him up in all the Capitol buildings. And I know they did in one or two. And
they put it in the manger scene.
Yeah, they put it in the manger scene. And so that tells me right there, if our country is letting them have a statue of Satan with kids on his lap, for one thing, and having a baby devil in our Capitol buildings, that tells me our country has gone to hell. I'm sorry. And we need to be fighting for Christ. We need to be standing up for our Lord. And
Jesus is coming.
Jesus is coming. You know, that's all there is to it. Yeah.
Can you tell them about the statue of the UN?
Oh, yeah. I'm sorry. I hate to mention this, too. And they put up a statue at the UN. I'm sure y'all probably seen that. And it's actually out of the Bible. It's of a leopard with bear claws and eagle wings, exactly like it's described in Revelation and in Daniel. So that's our UN. Them are supposed to be the people that are protecting the world. And they're calling it a statue to protect whatever their craft is. And I'm telling you, that all this, seeing all this, is telling me that things are fixing to get really rough and fast. So, man, you hold on to your faith. You get out there and you tell people about Jesus as much as you can. And if you are embarrassed, if you are shy, you pray for the Lord to give you strength to get over that and to be bold for Christ. And I'm going to tell you flat out, because we get it. People come against us and they'll tell us flat out they don't want nothing to hear about it and blah, blah, blah and all this. You just say, okay, I'll pray for you. That's going to make him even more mad, but you just keep on And if they are not going to listen to you whatsoever at all, you dust your feet off and you walk away from them. Do not let that spirit jump onto you, because it will. It'll try. It'll try to get you right then and then. Mm-hmm. And you just pray it off and be strong. And please, guys, read your word. Read this. Do not take my word for nothing. You read this. Mm-hmm. This is the truth right here. And I love you guys. I'm sorry to end off with a doom and gloom, but it's getting serious. It is getting serious. And our country has jumped on in it for some reason. I don't know why. I do not know why. Because that's not the America. That's not the America that I know. That's the plan. You got it.
So
that's right. You be praying for our country. And be praying. Just pray, pray, pray all day long, all night. Don't stop praying.
Look at the difference in our seasons. Yeah. We can't even tell.
I know. 70-something degrees out there.
Supposed to be winter.
It's crazy. I think there's going to be a lot to pay for that. It's going to be cold.
Next week.
And that flip switches like it did last year. That was nuts. Okay, guys. I'm not going to take time to do praise reports right now. I'm praying that everybody had a good year, and I'm praying that next year's better. But I'm going to close in prayer. We're going to eat, fellowship, have a good time, and we're going to just praise God. And you know what? If you don't have anything going on Monday through Friday, 10 to 2, please come by and hang out with us. And just like I tell you, sitting down and listening to people. People need somebody to talk to.
Yeah.
They need it. I mean it. It is. I've never seen such desperation in my life than the last 2 months. I mean, in their eyes.
We still need volunteers.
We still need volunteers.
Chuck and I did it one day by ourselves.
Yeah, that was fun. And we were busy. All of our volunteers were gone. It was just me and Pat. We were, you take that area. I'll get this area. Go, go, go. It was funny. We had a good time.
We did.
And so we need people to put stuff in the baggies, like I always tell you, to serve and to serve over here and to just to love on people. That's what we got to do, is love on people. Show them the love of Christ. All right, I love you guys. We're going to pray. All right.
Can I get prayed for a total body healing?
In the name of Jesus, slap her in the forehead. Let's get it right.
You done
now? I'm glad you're back,
yes,
honey.
Thank you.
Father God, we ask you, Lord, for total healing.
Yes.
Thank you, Father God. Lord, we ask you to bless the food that we're about to eat and the fellowship we're going to have, Lord. And we thank you, Lord. Thank you, Father God, for our loved ones that have passed away, Lord. We ask you that you just hold them tight and love on them, Lord. And we thank you for them, Father God. Lord, we thank you for Jesus. We thank you for all that you have done for us. Thank you for all the blessings. Thank you for this beautiful year, Lord. Let next year just be the best year ever, Father God. Lord, we love you. We praise your name. In the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. Amen.
Amen.
All right. All right. You know how to set it up. Let's set it up.